हेलो एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? Am I audible to you? Tell me, dear. Say yes or no. Yes. What are you discussing in the previous class? Tell me. What are we discussing in the next class, previous class? Appendicular system. Let's see. I'm going to tell you the appendicular escalator. Let's see. Appendicular skeleton. Let's see here. We have appendicular skeleton in that it consists of girdles and limbs. Agreed? Girdles is two there. One is pectoral girdle and one is pelvic girdle. Agreed? There are two girdles, and I have already told you what is the function of girdle. It is going to connect limb to the axial skeleton. Agreed? Pectoral girdle and pelvic girdle. Pectoral girdle consists of scapula and clavicle. And pelvic girdle consists of coxal bone. Agreed? Pectoral girdle consists of scapula and clavicle. And pelvic girdle consists of coxal bones. Agreed? No issues? Let's see. Pectoral girdle is two and each consisting of two bones. So total number of bones will be four. And what about pelvic girdle? It consists of two coxal bones. What? Two coxal bones. Getting my point? So there are two pelvic girdle, each consisting of one bone, hence total number of two. So how many total number of bones are there in the girdle? Four in the pectoral girdle in total and two in the pelvic girdle in total. Agreed? Coxal bone is formed by fusion of three bones, ilium, ischium, and pubis. Agreed, dear? Everyone, you can write it down, the girdle thing. After that, I will show you the diagrams. Agreed? You people are not speaking. Please just speak up.
Just a second, sir.
Yes. Thank you.
done, sir.
Done, everyone. Let's see. In limbs, upper limb having 30 bone and lower limb also having 30 bone. Upper limb having 30 bones and that are humerus, radius, ulna, humerus, radius, ulna. Getting my point? They are one. Carpals are one, are eight. Metacarpals are 5 and phalanges are 14. How many total number of bones are there in this upper limb? It is 30. And how many bones are there in the lower limb? It's femur, it's tibia, it's fibula, it's patella. Each are there in one in number, tarsals 7, metatarsals 5, and phalanges 14. So that is also 30 bones. Only difference here, carpals are 8 and tarsals are 7 in number. Agreed, dear? Everyone can write it down. Done. Done, everyone.
Just a second. Done,
sir. Done. Now the pectoral girdle. Let's see, dear. We'll talk about pectoral girdle. You can see over here. This is the scapula bone. This one you can see clearly. And this is the clavicle bone. Agreed? Can you see both of them? Can you see both of them? See, this is a scapula. This triangular flat bone is a scapula. This one that you can see over here. This is a scapula. And this S-shaped bone is clavicle. S-shaped bone is clavicle. Agreed? Done? So let's see over here. If you will see from the dorsal side, this structure is known as a spine of a scapula. Spine of a scapula, and it proceeds towards this side as acromion process. Acromion process. Agreed? Acromion process. Done. Acromion process. You can see the clavicle is going to join the acromion process only in this diagram. Can you observe, dear? Done. Clavicle is going to join the acromion process only to form acromioclavicular joint. Acromioclavicular joint. Agreed? Everyone? Acromioclavicular joint. Can you see this? And clavicle on the medial side, joint to sternum, to form a sternoclavicular joint. Agreed? Now, Isos, you people have understood a spine of a scapula and acromion process?
Yes, sir.
on the front side you can see coracoid process. What? Coracoid process. Agreed? Coracoid process. Noisels in the from the anterior side you can see it do not articulate to any of the bone, rather it gives attachment to many muscles. Just below the acromion process, you people can observe this thing, the glenoid cavity. What? Which cavity?
Glenoid.
Glenoid cavity. Glenoid cavity to which head of humerus is going to join. Now, can I say in a scapula, you people need to remember three things. One is the spine of a scapula. Its extension is acromion process only. Is it its extension or not? Is it its extension or not? Tell me, dear. Yes. And then the glenoid cavity to which head of humerus joins. Agreed? Let's see. Done? Yes. Now you can see pectoral girdle consists of a triangular bone scapula and a S-shaped bone known as clavicle. Scapula, the location is dorsal part of thorax, situated between second and seventh rib. Getting my point? It is a flat bone, triangular bone. It is acromion process. A spine of scapula extends at acromion process. Acromion process attaches to clavicle, and coracoid process situated in the anterior in the scapula, and glenoid cavity is present below acromion process. Getting my point? To which head of humerus fits. Done? Done? Done, everyone? Please write it down. Done.
Done, sir.
Let's see. We are done with scapula, especially its extension and in which region it is situated. Agreed? Done. Now, another is clavicle. Clavicle is a bone which is S-shaped, also known as collarbone, joins medially to sternum to form sternoclavicular joint, and laterally to the acromion process to form acromioclavicular joint. It is convex in front. You can say when it is close to sternum, and it is concave when it is away from sternum. Agreed? Medially joins to sternum. It is a S-shaped bone. And laterally articulates with acromion process of scapula. Done? Please write it down. Done, everyone. This is your clavicle. So, pectoral girdle is done. There are two bones, no issues. Now we'll talk about pelvic girdle. What? Pelvic girdle. Pelvic girdle. You can see there are three bones which fused to form the coxal bone. It was ilium, it was ischium, and it was pubis. You can see ilium I have made with orange color, getting my point. Pubis I have made with red color, and ischium I have made with white color. There is a foramen inside ischium that is known as obturator foramen. Getting my point? So coxal bone is formed by fusion of ilium, ischium, and pubis. Agreed, dear? And you can see there is a blue color cartilage present between the pubis to form pubic symphysis. To form what? Pubic symphysis. Agreed, dear everyone? Agreed? Which is made up of white fibrous cartilage. Symphysis, what is written? That means white fibrous cartilage is present over there. On this, a hormone name is relaxin. The name of the hormone is relaxin. Getting my point? That hormone is going to work on pubic symphysis and dilate it during the childbirth. Relax it during the childbirth, due to which the birth canal dilates. Done, dear? Agreed? No issues? Then,
so we are writing, sir, just a second.
Okay, please write down. Write it down, I'm coming back in a minute. Done, everyone? Done, everyone. Am I audible to you, dear?
Yes, sir.
Please do it. The concept of relaxing we are going to study in 12th. So please see this thing over here or not. Just a minute. I think my screen sharing has screen sharing has stopped. Just a minute. Just a minute here. Done. Are we done with the girdles? Are we done with the girdles? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Now upper limb. Upper limb having humerus, ulna, radius. Humerus, ulna, and radius. Getting my point? No issues? Then these are the metacarpal. Let me explain it to you in another diagram. Let's see. Over here, the humerus, the radius, the ulna, the carpals. These are the carpals, which are 8 in number. Then metacarpals. Metacarpals, getting my point, and phalanges. 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 Done. So this is there. This is the elbow joint. This is the elbow joint. That you people can observe. And this is the wrist joint that you people can see. Okay. Later on, we will discuss about this under the section joint. You all can write it. Would you like to draw it?
Yes, sir.
Please draw. Please inform me once you are done. Here is a muscle. Here is a muscle in your shoulders. In this area, you all can observe a prominent muscle that is attached to deltoid ridge. So if somebody will ask you deltoid ridge is present in which bone, what will you say? Tell me, dear.
Humerus.
It is humerus. Okay, you people draw. I'm just coming from washroom. Okay. Yes, dear. I am there. Understood this thing? Let's see.
So just a second, we're labeling the diagram.
Okay, please label.
Done, sir.
Done. Yes. Can you people observe similarly? The lower limb. Can you people observe?
Yes, sir.
Can you observe similarly? Here is the femur, here is the tibia, then fibula. Okay, and here is a bone over here. Can you see? This is kneecap or patella.
Yes, sir.
Patella, done. Fibula, tarsals, metatarsals. And phalanges. Then now you can observe one thing in the elbow joint. Both the both the two bones are there, radius as well as ulna. But in the knee joint, it is not like so. Only two bones are there: your fibula and your femur. Getting my point? Tibia and femur. Fibula is going to join to tibia only. It is not joining to femur. Yes or no? It is joining the tibia only. It is not joining the femur. Agreed, dear? Everyone? The femur, the tibia, the fibula, okay, and the patella, okay. Femur, tibia, and fibula. Then tarsals, you can see, metatarsals, you can see, phalanges. There is a change in number of tarsals. Carpals are 8, tarsals are only 7. Because patella is also known as kneecap. Another thing, patella is a sesamoid bone. Which bone? sesamoid bone. That means it is derived from or formed by ossification of tendons. Agreed here? Please see to it. Femur, tibia, fibula, knee joint, you people have to remember carefully because only two bones are there. Patella is present on the anterior side of it, not the part of joint. Just a minute. Yes, you all can draw. Femur, tibia, fibula, tarsals, metatarsals, phalanges. Are you done with this? Sesamoid bone, people have understood. What is tendon? Tendon is going to connect a muscle to the bone. Agreed here? Done?
Just a second, sir.
No issues. Thank you.
Answer.
Done, everyone. Let's see. There are few more things that is there. Let's see. Few things are there for your references only. You will go and see some questions, and you will not be able to solve for that purpose only. Just a minute. I think internet is slow today. That is why again and again things are stopping. Yes. Just a minute here. These days my app is not working at times. Yes, can you see over here? Few more things are there. Here, I have told you that deltoid ridge part, deltoid ridge or deltoid tuberosity is present on the humerus. Now you can observe one thing. Two things are there. One is olecranon process, and one is coronoid process. Sorry, first coronoid process, then coronoid fossa. Can you observe in which bone coronoid process is there, and in which bone coronoid fossa is there? It is present at your elbow joint. It is present at your elbow joint. Getting my point? Anteriorly, if you will view it from the anterior side, you will get to know the coronoid process. In which bone it is there? Apart from Sarada, others can also answer. So yes, you are not there today in the class.
Sir, is it ulna?
Yes, it is ulna. And where is coronoid fossa? Is present?
Humerus.
Yeah. Likewise, if you will see posteriorly, olecranon process. Olecranon process is present in ulna, and olecranon fossa is present in. It is present in humerus. Agreed? Done? Done, everyone? Noise source. Now, there is magnified view of the wrist and the hand region. You all can see. Now, patella was the sesamoid bone of upper limb. Cruciform is the sesamoid bone of. Patella was the sesamoid bone of lower limb. Lower means limb means the hind limb, and cruciform is the sesamoid bone of upper limb. You all can see. Although here also there are two elevations, bony ridges are present, which is sesamoid in nature. So, for you people, cruciform is important, nothing else.
बीच में हूँ आपके। हाय आदि
डन एवरीवन। नेम्स यू नीड नॉट टू, नेम्स यू नीड नॉट टू रिमेंबर, दैट मच यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू रिमेंबर, दैट इज नॉट एट ऑल रिक्वायर्ड। ओके, दैट इज नॉट एट ऑल रिक्वायर्ड। दिस इज द एक्चुअल डायग्राम दैट आई हैव मेड। ओके, आई हैव ड्रॉन, दिस इज द डिजिटल फॉर्मूला। सी, डिजिटल फॉर्मूला इज ऑल्सो नोन एज फैलेंजियल फॉर्मूला। कुछ फॉर्मूला, फैलेंजियस फॉर्मूला, टू इन द थंब एंड इन रेस्ट ऑफ द फिंगर्स इट इज थ्री। अग्री?
So what is it also called?
What? Digital, so, phalangeal. Phalanges are there, na? From phalanges, it is phalangeal formula. Phalangeal formula. Digit or phalanges, both are the similar things.
So this is specific to human.
Yes, it is there in the upper limb as well as lower limb. It is similar, isn't it?
So it's specific to humans, right?
Yes, it is for humans only. I'm talking about human only. It may be there in others also, but especially at least in human, it is like so only. Done, everyone? We are done now. Let's see. We'll discuss types of joint. We'll discuss types of joint. Basically, on the basis of component and movement that is going to be, you can say, permitted, joints are of three types. One is fibrous joint, another is cartilaginous joint, and one more is synovial joint. Agreed, dear? Agreed, dear? Fibrous joint, cartilaginous joint, and synovial joint. Do you people agree? And able to see?
Yes, sir.
Others are not able to see. Only Shraddha is able to see. Says you are there today. You are not speaking at all. Sri Gauri is not saying anything. Raghuram is not saying anything. Pooja is not saying anything. Aditi is not saying anything. Not even a single word. Neither asking questions. Yes. Let's see, dear. Fibrous joint is of three types. One is sutures, one is syndesmosis, and one is interosseous membrane. One is sutures, one is syndesmosis, and another is interosseous membrane. seat here. Cartilaginous joint is synchondrosis, synchondrosis and symphysis. Symphysis. Agreed? We will discuss everything and synovial joint. Let's see types of joint. First thing, synchondrosis word is used when at joint hyaline cartilage is there. If at joint hyaline cartilage is there, and symphysis is there when at joint white fibrous cartilage is there. Here, yes or no? Done. And you see, so if symphysis, like pubic symphysis is there, in that case, what is there? White fibrous cartilage is there only. Symphysis means white fibrous cartilage is cartilaginous joint. Agreed? Sorry, everyone? Agreed? Everyone? Tell me, dear. Now, synovial joint.
So what's epi and diaphysis?
Epiphysis is this is the long bone. This is its terminal end, bulging end. It is epiphysis and diaphysis. In between only hyaline cartilage is there. This is also known as growth plate. On that growth hormone is going to act, and from here only the elongation of bone will take place. Done, dear? Done, everyone? No issues? Done. Now, synovial. Let's see. Synovial joint is this white color structure is the bone. Bone. And can you see at its end a blue color covering is there? This covering, can you people see?
Yes, sir.
This covering, can you people see? What are they? They are articular cartilages. What? They are articular cartilages. Just. They are articular cartilages. Done? They are articular cartilages. Everyone, can you observe what is the function of articular cartilage? It is going to make movement of joint very smooth, joint very smooth. If articular cartilage is there, joint is going to move smoothly. Bone is not going to rub against each other. Done.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you all can copy. First, draw this. Write it down. Then draw the next diagram. First, try it.
Done, sir.
Then let's see. Seeing this joint, the bone is there, the articular cartilage is there. Agreed? And you see, the white color capsule is there. Yes or no? White color capsule is there. This is known as articular capsule. You all can see. This is known as this is the joint capsule. Agreed? And inside the white membrane, there is a red color lining. That is known as synovial membrane. Yes or no? That is known as synovial membrane. Yes or no? Done?
Yes, sir.
Synovial membrane. And synovial membrane is going to secrete synovial fluid. The synovial membrane is going to secrete synovial fluid. Agreed, dear? Tell me. Done. We will discuss few diseases also in this segment itself. Please see to it. Once you will draw, please let me know.
Answer.
Then let's see here. This is there. Now you see, if in the joint space, what will happen? Uric acid crystal will deposit. Uric acid crystal will deposit. What will happen in that case? Tell me. The patient is going to develop gout because those crystal will deposit on the joint surface, and when that person will try to move the joint, especially in the morning, a sharp pain is going to be there, because due to deposition of that crystal, joint surface is going to be rubbed against each other. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. After that, in many cases, articular cartilage is damaged. Getting my point? Because of damage to that articular cartilage, what will happen? There is difficulty in movement of joint. And that is known as osteoarthritis. Getting my point? And then rheumatoid arthritis is what? There is a, you can say it is an autoimmune disease in which one antibody known as a rheumatic factor is formed, and that is going to cause first proliferation of the synovial membrane. More and more synovial fluid will be formed. It is proliferative synovitis. Synovitis means inflammation. If inflammation will be there, permeability of blood vessel will increase and more fluid will be formed. Because of that extra fluid pressure, you will not be able to move the joint. Yes or no? Patient will not be able to move the joint. And in that case, what will happen? Some crystals are going to deposit. And that is, granules are going to deposit. That is known as pannus. 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 So these three diseases are there that I have finished over here only. Later on, only few are left that we will discuss. agree here, dear? You people are done with this? Understood these three digits?
Almost, sir. Just a minute.
Okay.
Answer.
Everyone? Done, dear? Now, let's see. Let's see. We have all the types of joints. Sorry. It is there in the one note only, not in the note only. Types of joint that we have described, in that only these joints are there. Please read out fibrous joint. First you write down, then I will explain it to you people. Because in that case, you will have fair bit of idea for discussing. Thank you. dandier,
just a second, sir, the last part. Done, everyone. Done, sir.
Let's see what you can see in this. What you can see in this fibrous joint. One bone is there, and another bone is there. That is joined by dense, irregular connective tissue. Dense, irregular connective tissue. Yes or no? What have you observed that this, you can say, the difference between sutures, syndesmosis, and interosseous membrane? This is the diagram of interosseous membrane. Okay. What have you observed? Please let me know. In sutures, bones are very close. It is there in the cranial bones. In sutures, bones are there in bones are very close. Agreed? No issues. So very little amount of what dense irregular connective tissue is present, and it do not provide any kind of movement. You have to go by this only, which is written in NCRT. There is no movement that is there. If you will see in the syndesmosis, this is the diagram of syndesmosis. A little bit more space is there, and you can see some observable amount of dense irregular connective tissue. And in interosseous membrane, it is still further more space and more dense irregular connective tissue is there. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. So very little space and very little connective tissue is there in the sutures, slightly more in syndesmosis, and slightly more and still more in interosseous membrane. You people can observe the distal tibiofibular joint. The distal tibiofibular joint. Getting my point? Distal tibiofibular joint. And here is the interosseous membrane. Agreed, dear? Tell me. And one special type of joint is there in the between the tooth socket and the tooth. tooth is joined in tooth socket with the help of periodontal ligament. That is also a syndesmosis, which is known as gomphosis. A special name is given, nothing else. Very dear, you all can see. If you want to draw the diagram, you can draw. Getting my point? So three kind of fibrous joint is possible. Done, dear?
Done, sir.
How we do? Yes. Let's see. So you people have understood the fibrous joint, sutures, syndesmosis, and interosseous membrane. Clearly, now cartilaginous joint. It is also going to lack synovial cavity. It also allow a little or no movement. Getting my point? Here, articulating bones are tightly connected by either hyaline cartilage and fibrocartilage. If it is hyaline cartilage, then synchondrosis. If it is fibrous cartilage, then it is symphysis. I have told you both the examples. You people can write it down. Done, everyone? Done. We'll talk about types of synovial joint. How many types of synovial joints are there that we need to see? Actually, you will see now. It is based on, basically, the basic thing is, it is based on types of, you can say, or shape of the articulating surfaces. And articulating surfaces are those part of the bone which is taking part in the joint formation. Can you observe in ball and socket type joint? One articulating surface is like a ball and another is like a socket. Can you people observe?
Yes, sir.
Your shoulder joint and hip joint. Please write it down. It is triaxial joint. X, Y, Z, three axes are there. It can move in all of them. In hinge joint, you all can see in the door of your house, door is connected to the wall with the help of a hinge. If you will observe, it is something like that only. Okay. One bone having deep concave articulating surface and one is having the convex articulating surface. And they are going to on the articular surface. It is going to move only in one direction or one axis actually. No direction. It is the elbow joint, the knee joint, and interphalangeal joint. Yes or no? Okay, let's write down. Thank you.
Done, sir.
Done. Pivot joint. We have already discussed. Pivot means a support. Pivot means a support. Agreed? Pivot means a support. Agreed, dear? You can see this is acting like a pivot. Okay? I have shown you people in the atlas and axis. We have discussed vertebral columna. Atlas and axis, and here it is between radius and ulna. You can write that.
Answer.
Done. Gliding joint. What is the meaning of term gliding? What is the meaning of glide? It is the simplest synovial joint, because for gliding, the surface should be flatter or flat. Okay, so you can write it down. Gliding joint. Here, two articular surfaces are flat, and they can slip over each other a bit. Saddle, you people know? Saddle, it is kept on the back of horse. That is known as saddle. Just imagine the shape and compare that shape over here. It is something like that only. It is saddle. Okay? Example you need to remember.
So could you scroll down?
Yes, down. This one, gliding. It is not gliding joint you are asking for?
Sir, saddle joint, sir.
Done.
Answer.
Angular or condyloid joint, you see, or ellipsoid joint. Again, the shape is like an ellipse. You can see. It is like an ellipse. Okay. You can write this down also. Done, dear. Thank you.
Answer.
Done, everyone. Now few more disease that is left. Most of them we have discussed. One or two we can see. Just see dear, myasthenia gravis, I have told you people, you have understood the neuromuscular junction. I have discussed with you people neuromuscular junction. If you can say receptor of acetylcholine will be damaged, in that case what will happen? The acetylcholine will not be able to join generate the action potential in the muscle fiber. In that case, what will happen? Fatigue will be there, weakness will be there, and paralysis will be there. Muscular dystrophy, I have discussed with you people in detail. That muscle dystrophin, muscle protein dystrophin, I have told you in that diagram, which is connecting the myofibrils to the sarcolemma. Agreed, dear? So if protein dystrophin will be destroyed, in that case, muscular dystrophy is going to be there. Then tetany. You all know, calcium is not required only for muscle contraction, but it is also required for membrane stability. See, we are going to discuss nerve conduction from sometime now. Getting my point, I will let you know that from, you can say on both the sides of the membrane, the electrolytes or the charge should be in a proportionate manner. Otherwise, the membrane is going to lose its property. If calcium will decrease too much, membrane will become unstable. And with simple stimulus also, it will start contracting rapidly or wildly. So tetany is going to be there. Okay. If low blood calcium will be there, which hormone do you think can cause tetany? It can be caused by parathyroid hormone in case of its hyposecretion, because in your blood the level of calcium is maintained by parathyroid hormone. We are going to read that in the chemical control and coordination chapter. Yes, dear. Everyone, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Yes. Please see to it. Write it down. We will discuss nerve conduction after the break. Okay. We will be meeting at 6:15. Are you people back? Let's see dear, nervous tissue. If we have to discuss nervous system, we need to know the nervous tissue first. Need to know the nervous tissue first. What is nervous tissue? Tell me. Actually, your nervous tissue is first thing that you need to know is ectodermal in origin. Is it ectodermal in origin? Yes or no? Say yes or no. It consists of neurons. It consists of neurons and neuroglial cells. Neurons can detect, can conduct, and transmit the impulse. Neurons can detect, can conduct, and can transmit the impulse. Agreed, dear, everyone? No issues. And another is neuroglial cells, that is supporting cells. Agreed? One is neuroglial cells. Done, dear? Say yes or no. Are you people there?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, neurons. One thing is, glial cell constitute more than 50% of the nervous tissue. It constitute more than 50% of the nervous tissue. Okay. And if you will talk about parts of neurons, it is dendrites, the cell bodies, and the axon. Dendrite, the cell body, and the axon. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Let's see, neuroglial cells is of two types. One is macroglial cells and one is microglial cells. Macroglial cells constitute astrocytes, the oligodendrocytes, and the Schwann cells. Astrocyte forms blood-brain barrier. See, your nervous tissue is very sensitive to your body. Nervous tissue is very sensitive to your body. So astrocyte is going to wrap around the blood vessels, wrap around the blood vessel. Actually, it is present between the blood vessels and the nervous tissue. Okay? Anything coming to the nervous tissue that will pass through astrocytes. So anything noxious or harmful will first go to which cell? Will first go to which cell? Tell me. Tell me, dear. First go to which cell?
Neuroglial cell.
Yes. And then oligodendrocytes. It forms the myelin sheath in CNS. The Schwann cells, it forms myelin sheath in PNS. Agreed, dear? Astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, and Schwann cells. Astrocyte forms blood-brain barrier. And because the astrocyte is always receiving a noxious stimuli, so there is more chances of developing a tumor, which is astrocytoma, the brain tumor I'm talking about. Yes or no, dear? The brain tumor I'm talking about. Yes or no? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes. And what about microglial cells? It originates from the blood. It originates from the blood. It is phagocytic in action and it is mesodermal in origin. It originates from the blood. It is phagocytic in action and it is mesodermal in origin. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone. So can you solve this question? Solve it. you solve this question? You solved, everyone?
Yes, sir.
It is microglial cells. The neuron is going to consist of dendrite, cell body, and axon. You all can write this thing. Please write it down, and then we will move to the next diagram. Done. Are we done?
Yes, sir.
Let's see here. Now, parts of neuron. These small processes are known as dendrite. Okay. This structure is cell body, and this is axon. This is axon. Agree, dear? Axon. There are three parts. Getting my point? You can see there is a nucleus inside the cell body. Main means what is nucleus? Is the main center of any cell. Nerve fiber means a nervous tissue cell. That means a neuron. Getting my point? And you can observe here is the axon. The point at which axon is joined to the cell body is known as axon hillock. Axon hillock. Getting my point? Axon hillock. Then you can see over axon, there is a covering known as myelin sheath. and here is the Schwann cells. Agreed? Because myelin sheath is wrapped over the Schwann cell only, that is why you can see this elevation. You can see this elevation. Yes or no? Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
So, dendrite is there, cell body is there, and axon is there. You can see at places the myelin sheath is absent. That is known as node of Ranvier. At places, the myelin sheath is absent. That is known as node of Ranvier. Agreed, dear? It is known as node of Ranvier. At this point, lots of channels and pumps are present. At this point, lots of channels and pumps are present. Agreed, everyone? Now you can see one thing. This is axon terminal, which is terminating into synaptic knob. Synaptic knob. It contains synaptic vesicle. What? It contains synaptic vesicle. Agreed? Agreed, everyone? Now you can observe few things inside the cell body. Can you see these small granules? This is known as Nissl's granules. Nissl's granules are rough endoplasmic reticulum. So you can, and at places, it is also written as ribosome. It is rough endoplasmic reticulum, and at places it is written as ribosome. Nissl's granules are present in dendrite and the cell body. Where all? The dendrite and the cell body. Done, dear?
Yes, sir.
Dendrite and the cell body. The dendrite and the cell body. It is absent in axon. Being rough endoplasmic reticulum, you people can understand what should be its function. It is protein synthesis only. Yes or no? Tell me. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you all can write it. Are we done?
So just a minute, sir, we're drawing.
Done, dear?
Yes, sir.
Done? Let's see. Let's see. I have made a magnified view of this one over here. This is synaptic vesicle. This is synaptic vesicle. You see, synaptic nerve, which is going to contain synaptic vesicle, and inside synaptic vesicle, what is present? The neurotransmitters. What is present? The neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters can be excitatory and can be inhibitory. Okay. excitatory is going to conduct the impulse. Getting my point? Further, inhibitory is going to stop the conduction. Agreed? See over here. Neurotransmitter. If acetylcholine is the neurotransmitter, that neuron is known as cholinergic fiber. And if you can say the neurotransmitter is acetylcholine, that is known as adrenergic fiber. Done, dear? So cholinergic fiber and adrenergic fiber. You all can see over here. Done? Done, everyone? Done, everyone?
So just a second.
Yes.
Done, sir.
Done. Now, see, actually, we will talk about types of neurons now. There are two, on the basis of direction of conduction, there is afferent fiber and efferent fiber. Yes or no? Afferent fiber is one that carries impulse towards the CNS. Afferent fiber is one that carries impulse towards the CNS. Agreed, dear? And efferent fiber is one that carries impulse away from CNS. Okay. This is a afferent fiber. This is a efferent fiber. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? Then, nerve is going to be of three types. Sensory, motor, and mixed. Sensory, motor, and mixed. Sensory nerve, which is purely sensory, it is having only afferent fiber. The nerve which is purely sensory, it is only having afferent fiber. And the nerve which is purely motor is only having efferent fiber. Because it is taking this thing, this is motor. And in mixed nerve, it is both afferent and efferent fiber. Yes or no, dear? So, neuron is something else. Nerve is, you can say nerve is going to contain lots of neuron, lots of neuron. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
See you. done.
Answer.
Let's see. On the basis of presence or absence of myelin sheath. Neurons are of two types. One is myelinated, another is non-myelinated. See, what are the differences? Let's observe first. Swan cell secretes myelin sheath. Swan cells do not secrete myelin sheath. That means swan cell is present in both the cases. Okay, getting my point? Wherever myelin is there, it will look whitish. It will look whitish in appearance. Okay, and wherever two kind of matter is there in your nervous system, one is white matter, another is gray matter. Wherever myelin is there, that will be white matter, and wherever myelin is absent, that will be gray matter. Yes or no? So you people can observe, this is the brain of yours, cerebral cortex. In the outer side, what is concentrated? Is it axon or the cell body? Is it axon or the cell body? On the outer side, I'm asking for. What is concentrated on the outer side? Tell me, dear.
The cell body.
Cell body. Is there any myelin present on the cell body?
Yes, sir.
No. It is not present. So outer side myelin is absent, so it will look gray, and inside it is myelinated axon, so it will look white. So outer side of cerebral cortex is made up of gray matter and inner side is made up of white matter. It is opposite in case of a spinal cord. Inner side is gray matter and outer side is white matter. Yes or no? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is neurilemma? This is the axon. This is the axon. And outside axon, there are cells. And those cells are known as what? Swan cells. Wherever myelin is not there, Swan cell itself is going to make a cover. Wherever myelin sheath is not there, Swan cell itself is going to make a cover, and that cover is known as what? Neurilemma. That cover is known as what? Neurilemma. Agreed, dear? Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Done? Everyone, now this one. One more thing. Have you seen this formula in physics? R equals to rho L upon A?
Yes, sir.
Same is followed by neuron also, because neuron do have electrical conduction only. Neurons do have electrical conduction only. So R equals to, so longer neuron having more resistance and thicker neuron having less resistance. You people can agree with this point of mine. This point you people can read first, then I will give you time to write it down. Done, dear?
Yes, sir.
Done? You can write it down. Especially the neurilemma thing. Myelinated, non-myelinated. Done, dear. Are we done with this?
Answer.
Let's see, on the basis of cell processes, dendrites and axons are cell processes. Yes or no? They are unipolar, they are bipolar, they are multipolar, and they are pseudo unipolar. You can see over here. Actually, what happens, if you will see over here, cell body is there and only one dendrite is there. That is unipolar. Only one axon and one cell body. It is there in invertebrates. Bipolar. This is the photoreceptor cells and this is the ganglion cell. In between is the bipolar neuron. Agree, dear? Everyone? In between is the bipolar neuron. No issues? It connects, it is there in the retina of eye. It connects photoreceptor cell, that is rod and cone cells, to the ganglion cells. Multipolar, I have made over here. One axon, many dendrites. No issues? One axon, many dendrites. And one is pseudo unipolar. See, it is coming like this. Only one cell process is there, then divide into two. One act like a dendrite, another act like a axon. Agreed, dear? Everyone? So, unipolar, bipolar, multipolar, and pseudo unipolar neurons are there. It is on the basis of types of cell processes. Agreed? It is there in the dorsal root ganglion of the spinal cord. We are going to read this thing from sometime now. Okay, or in the next class. Done? Everyone, please write it down. Done, everyone? Done, everyone. Everyone, unipolar, bipolar, multipolar, and pseudo unipolar. Done?
Done, sir.
Now, we'll talk about conduction of nerve impulse. Let's see, what is the meaning of conduction? How an impulse travel along the axon. It is the traveling of neuron, impulse on axon of the neuron. Let's see here. This is the plasma membrane of nervous tissue, nervous cell actually, neurons. That is known as axolemma. In the axon part, it is known as axolemma. Agreed? And you know that plasma membrane is like this, na? This hydrophilic tail head, hydrophobic tail, like that arrangement is there, na? Like that arrangement is there, na? Say yes or no. Say yes or no. This kind of arrangement is there, na? In plasma membrane. Yes. So, what is this? This is transmembrane protein, which will let things go through this. This is known as channel. Yes or no? This is known as channel. You can observe the axon. See, this is the plasma cytoplasm present inside the axon, that is known as exoplasm. And this is the extracellular space. See the concentration in extracellular space. Sodium is there in a concentration 141 milli equivalent per liter, and potassium is 4 milli equivalent per liter. In the exoplasm, sodium is 14 milli equivalent per liter and potassium is 139 milli equivalent per liter. Agreed, dear? Agreed, dear? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
This one and this one. Now, across the membrane, there are two things. One is pump and one is channel. Pump is going to transport against concentration gradient. Against the concentration gradient. That is meant for active transport. And channel is there for passive transport. It do not require energy. It can be voltage gated channel and it can be leaky channel. In many molds, you go now, gates are there that once you will go, you will move, you will be there, it will open up. And after that, it is going to be closed on itself. Yes or no? On its own. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. So that kind of gate is known as voltage gated. Only it will open when impulse will arrive. There are few leaky channels always open. Yes or no? They all are transmembrane proteins. Getting my point? So you have voltage gated sodium channel, voltage gated potassium channel, sodium potassium pump, and these are the leaky channels. Agreed? Agreed, everyone? Agreed, everyone? This one and this one. Can you see? Done?
Yes, sir.
Dekho isko. Let's see. Let's see. Can you correlate sodium Na plus in more amount in extracellular fluid and in less amount in intracellular fluid with evolution? Can you correlate this thing? Why sodium is present in more concentration outside the cell? Can you correlate? Then let's see, dear. Can you correlate this thing?
No, sir.
See where evolution has taken place, where the cell has originated. Tell me, dear.
So can you repeat?
I told where the cell has originated first. For the first time. Tell me, dear. Is it there in the ocean?
Yes,
sir. The first cell that has formed? And what is there in the oceanic water?
NaCl.
NaCl. So, same here also. All your cells are adapted like it require more Na plus in the extracellular space and less Na plus in the intracellular space. And more K plus in the intracellular fluid and less K plus in the extracellular fluid. Yes or no? tell me dear.
Yes sir.
Noise source. Now this is nerve conduction. You can see inside of the membrane is negative and outside of membrane is positive. Suresh, you are not speaking anything today, not even a word. Let's see what I want to tell you all. Here inside is negative. When this kind of thing is there now, on both the sides of a membrane, two different kind of charges are there. That is known as polarized membrane. What? Polarized membrane. Agreed here? That is known as polarized membrane. Agreed here? Everyone? Inside is when two different positive and negative are poles only, na? Positive and negative are pole only. You people read about these things, na? Dipole and all. So if any membrane having two different charge on its two sides, that is known as polarized membrane. Are the nerve fibers are you can say nerve or exolemma is a polarized membrane or not?
Yes,
exolemma is a polarized membrane or not? Is it there? Yes or no? Inside
yes,
is negative. Inside is negative and outside is positive. Can you observe? Outside is positive. Is there any specific reason for this? Is there any specific reason for this? See.
The concentration of ions.
Yes, there are three reasons. Getting my point? One, why it is inside it is negative. First thing is, inside the exoplasm, negatively charged proteins are present. What are they? Negatively charged proteins are there. Getting my point? This is one thing. Next thing is, in resting state, the membrane is more permeable for K plus and almost impermeable for Na plus. Agreed? In resting state, the membrane is more permeable for K plus and almost impermeable for K plus. Yes or no? Sorry, I think I have dictated it wrongly or in opposite manner. It is impermeable for Na plus and permeable for K plus. So if it is permeable for K plus, K plus is more inside. It will move out. If you are going to remove a positive charge from inside, what it will become? Negative inside, na? Say yes or no.
Yes,
you
sir.
Are because Na plus cannot move because it is impermeable at that time. Okay, and third thing, the sodium potassium pump is electrogenic. Why it is electrogenic? It throws 3 Na plus outside and takes only 2 K plus inside. It throws 3 Na plus outside and takes only 2 K plus inside. Agreed, dear? Done? Tell me?
Yes, sir.
You all can write it down. These are the important concepts that has to be understood. done, everyone? Done? Are we done?
Done, sir.
Let's see. Now I am going to decide a few things. I am going to put a electrode inside the membrane and one on the surface of the membrane. And going to connect it to the potentiometer. And what is the instrument potentiometer known for? To calculate the potential difference in a dear. So potential inside minus potential outside. When? At resting state. It is a convention that you are always going to differentiate or measure between inside and outside. Inside will come first. That is the convention that is made. Yes or no? Yes or no? If you are going to do like this, are you going to get potential inside minus potential outside? That is the potential difference between the two sides of the membrane. Yes or no? Potential difference between the two sides of the membrane. Yes or no? Say yes or no. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes or no? So let's see. It is at the resting state. What is the meaning of resting state in neurons? When no conduction is taking place. When no conduction is taking place. Agreed, everyone? No conduction is taking place. No conduction is taking place. So have you understood the definition of resting membrane potential? It is the potential difference between inside of the membrane and outside of the membrane when no conduction is taking place. It is minus 70 to minus 90 millivolt. If you are going to subtract positive from negative, it will be always negative. Agreed, dear? Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Done, everyone? Done, everyone? Are you people agree with all these things? Have you written this thing? Have you written all these three points of membrane being negative towards inside? Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now we are going to study the concept of threshold potential. You may have observed during the rainy season, some of your doors or doors in your house is going to be jammed. Yes or no? Have you observed that? And it is very difficult to open that door. Have you observed or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you have also. So tell me, dear, what had happened? You will require a minimum force. You will require a minimum force so that the gate should be opened. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is known as threshold. Will the gate open if you will apply a lesser force than that of threshold force? Will the gate open if you will apply a lesser force than the threshold force? Will it open?
No, sir.
It will not open. Similar thing is there, means some threshold potential is the minimum potential required for conduction of impulse. Anything which is lesser than threshold will not be conducted. Anything which is lesser than the threshold potential will not be conducted. Agreed, dear? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? Done, everyone? Have you understood concept of resting membrane potential and threshold potential clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Done? Conduction along the nerve fibers follows all or none law. Either the impulse will be conducted, okay, or will not be conducted. There is nothing like partial conduction that is there. There is nothing like partial conduction that is there. Yes or no? Partial conduction is a myth. That do not happen. Either it will be conducted all along the neuron, or it will not be conducted. Agree, dear? Agreed? Everyone? It will be conducted or it will not be conducted. It follows in nerve as well as muscle. It follows all or none law. Now, I'm going to tell you how things are getting conducted. Let's see, dear. Threshold potential has arrived. That leads to opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. That will lead to opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. If you are going to open the sodium channel, in that case, sodium will flow in which direction? Outside to inside or inside to outside? Which direction? If you will open the sodium channel, in that case, sodium will move in which direction? Outside to inside or inside to outside? Please let me know, dear. Tell me, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. The sodium will come in.
That will lead to influx of sodium ion. Influx of sodium ion. See, if sodium ion will come in, okay, it makes the membrane positive inside and it remains negative outside. It makes membrane positive inside and it remains negative outside. Okay. This happens only locally, only where the sodium channel is present. Only where the sodium channel is present. Okay. So, and away from it, it is still negative inside and positive outside. Yes or no? Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
So from positive to negative, the current is moving. From positive to negative, the current is moving. Is it moving or not? Is it moving or not? And this process is known as depolarization. I have told you it is a polarized membrane. Now it is getting depolarized. Yes or no, everyone? So depolarization is a process that has taken place due to which phenomena? Is it due to influx of sodium ion? Is it due to influx of sodium ion?
Yes, sir.
Done? Is it due to influx of sodium ion? So if somebody will ask you why depolarization is taking place, what will you answer? What will you answer?
Because of influx of sodium ion. Yeah.
Now, the opening of sodium channel is short-lived. Okay, it is short-lived only. It will be closed soon. It will be closed soon, you see. In that case, what happened? Sodium, is it trapped inside or not? Sodium is trapped inside or not? Sodium is trapped inside or not? Tell me, dear. Because without opening the channel, it cannot move. Yes or no? Yes or no? You people yes, are not answering. Yes. Now this sodium will repel the K plus present inside and opening of K plus channel will take place. That is known as efflux of K plus ion. K plus is moving out now. K plus is moving out. It will make everywhere negative inside and positive outside. Yes or no? It will make everywhere negative inside and positive outside. Yes or no? Because either sodium is moving in or potassium is moving out. The similar kind of charge movement is there. Yes or no? If sodium is coming and making things positive, potassium will go out, will make the things negative again. Yes or no? Again, the inside negative potential and outside positive potential is restored. Yes or no? That process is known as repolarization. Why this repolarization has taken place? Due to efflux of potassium ion. Yes or no, dear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Others can also answer. Let's see. So, and now what will happen? The charge becomes like the initial thing. Charge becomes like this only. Charge is similar, but the things are sodium is trapped inside and potassium is trapped outside. In that case, sodium potassium pump will act. It will throw 3Na plus out and it will take 2K plus in. Agreed, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Done? And it will return to the resting state. Yes or no? You all can note down. Read it nicely from NCERT. Let's see. Write it down nicely. Done.
Just a second.
done. So all these things are there. We will be meeting in the next class to study further. Bye everyone. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
I am sending you people the.